Hey guys, Jake with 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be continuing down the list of Duramax engines. We're going to be covering common problems and reliability issues with the LLY. The LLY came out in mid-year 2004 and was a replacement to the LB7. The main thing with the LLY was the addition of exhaust gas recirculation on all of the engines. Previously on the LB7, EGR was only featured on the vehicles that were sold in California. In addition to that, there were a number of other changes with the block, the internals, as well as the turbocharger as they switched over to a variable vane turbocharger. There were a number of issues with the LB7 fueling system, like the fuel injectors and the fuel pump. However, a lot of those issues were addressed and fixed in the LLY, and so there aren't any fueling issues with this engine. However, there were a couple design changes that did lead to some new problems that are unique to the LLY. One of the main things here is that they upgraded to a really large turbocharger. The turbocharger in the LLY is the largest one that's been used in a Duramax engine, even to date. The large turbocharger is great because it can make a significant amount of power without having to be upgraded. However, it does present a couple of problems with this engine that we're going to go ahead and talk about here in a minute. One other note is that for model year 2006, the LLY received a huge update and refresh. Probably 80% of the engine was completely changed, and to put things into perspective, the 2006 model year LLY is really just an LBZ that's tuned a little bit differently from the factory. So the LBZ that was released somewhere within 2006 was built off of the second generation LLY and is virtually the same thing. And so when we talk about the LLY here, we'll try to differentiate the issues between the early model and the 2006 year, just since they're very different engines. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the problems here. The problems here really fall into two buckets. The first one's heating and engine temperatures, and then the second bucket is performance modifications. With the first bucket of heating and engine temp problems, the biggest flaw to the LLY is with overheating. As I mentioned, they added the largest turbocharger to this, but the LLY also got the smallest radiator. And now all of the engines had an EGR cooler, which took up a little bit more cooling capacity from the radiator. So when you combine a large turbocharger with a small radiator and the addition of an EGR cooler, you get an engine that is prone to overheating. Additionally, the water pump and the engine fan are known to fail pretty frequently, which can also cause overheating. So those are two common problems within this overheating category that the LLY does face. Now, this isn't a problem for 2006 models since they got completely redesigned. One of the biggest reasons that this was a problem for the LLY is that the turbocharger inlet was extremely small and extremely restrictive. So one of the best ways to fix overheating or prevent overheating issues with the LLY is to get an upgraded turbo inlet that has a lot higher airflow. Additionally, just to cap off the overheating problem, this is a lot more common when towing. It's not quite as common for vehicles that aren't towing heavy loads, but if you do live in hot climates, this is certainly something that you could run into pretty frequently. The other problem with respect to heating is with the head gasket. All of these problems that we just talked about lead to overheating, but the other thing is it causes the engine to naturally run pretty hot and to run at a lot higher temperatures than are ideal for components like head gaskets, which are known to fail under high temperatures. Head gaskets are a normal wear and tear item. However, one of the things that is the most damaging to them is engine heat, and the fact that the LLY runs at high temperatures and is known to overheat causes the head gasket to fail a bit more frequently than you would expect. The problem with head gasket failure is that the book time to replace the head gasket is about 40 hours, since there are a ton of parts that you need to remove just to get to it. A skilled mechanic can do it probably in half the time, but it is a pretty big job from a labor standpoint. Again, not a problem for 2006 models because of the new design. The second bucket of problems with the LLY is performance modification related problems. These aren't problems that you really need to address or think about if you aren't planning on adding a tune and adding a bunch of bolt-on modifications to increase power a significant amount. So if you plan on staying under 500 wheel horsepower, these are probably less of an issue and something that you don't need to think about. But considering the turbocharger on this engine is very capable and that diesels are frequently modified, I wanted to go ahead and put these in the bucket of common problems. The first one is with bent rods. The LLY is said to be able to handle about 600 wheel horsepower on the stock rods. However, once you get above the 500 wheel horsepower ballpark, bent rods become a lot more common of a problem and a lot more frequent of an issue. And so once you get above 500 is when we recommend looking at upgrading the rods. The second thing is with the fuel pressure release valve. This is a spring-loaded valve that prevents the fuel rail pressure from getting too high. And so when fuel rail pressure gets too high, it bleeds off. The problem when you're running additional power is it puts a lot more force on the spring. The spring is known to wear down and become less effective. When that happens, the fuel rail valve will start bleeding pressure off, which will result in the engine not getting enough fueling, which causes a bunch of performance related issues. Again, not a problem for stock trucks, really only for anyone running 500 plus wheel horsepower. So that covers it for really the main problems on this engine. Another noteworthy mention is with the EGR system. There really aren't too many problems with the EGR system. The valve is known to gunk up a bit over time and it can either fail and get stuck open or stuck closed. However, that doesn't tend to happen until very high mileage. And alongside that, the EGR cooler and the catalytic converter really aren't problem areas either, but once you do start getting to really high mileage, those become common maintenance failure points. But they don't fail because of design flaws or any issue with those components themselves. They fail because they are somewhat maintenance items, and over time, especially across a lot of miles, they slowly deteriorate and can run into problems. So that covers it for our common problems on the LLY. This engine really isn't the most reliable when you start throwing additional power at it. However, if you plan on keeping it stock and you address the heating issues, by simply upgrading the turbo inlet and maybe looking into a couple other cooling related modifications, this is actually a very reliable engine. Its lack of tunability and its relatively small horsepower limits does probably put it lower on the list in terms of desirability, at least with the early models. The early models are probably the least desirable Duramax. The 2006 model is virtually the same as an LBZ, and so those are a lot less problematic. They don't have the low power capacity that the LLY has, and it also does not have the same overheating issues. And so the 2006 model is certainly superior from both a reliability and a performance standpoint than the earlier models are. Like I mentioned, very reliable when kept stock. That covers it for our video on common problems with the Duramax LLY. If you appreciate this content, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future Duramax content.